Hello, I am Seamus Donahue of EVE University, and this is an introduction to incursions in EVE Online. An incursion is an automated recurring event where Sancho Kuvaki sends his cybernetically mind-controlled minions to a particular constellation to try and abduct people off planets and turn them into more cybernetically mind-controlled minions. As a new player, your first experience with the incursions feature will be most likely when it suddenly hits the constellation you're currently in and interferes with your normal operations. This interference takes a few forms. First of all, you'll see an incursion profile in the upper left corner of the screen, either underneath or above the profile for the system. And you can collapse this if you wish. But let's expand it and let's take a look at the details. The first item, if you look at this row of icons, the first item here is that system-wide sinusoidal field jammers are in effect. In high security space, this isn't relevant because you're not allowed to activate sinusoidal fields anyway. For those who don't know what a sinusoidal field is, there are very large types of ships called capitals and supercapitals that are too big to fit through stargates. They can only travel to another solar system if a fleetmate is already in that other solar system and activates a sinusoidal field. The game doesn't allow sinusoidal fields in high security anyway, so in this particular constellation, the sino jammer is irrelevant. In low and null security constellations, however, it does mean that you cannot sino a capital ship into an incursion constellation. The next detail is that the financial systems are compromised. 50% reduction in Concord bounties. So if you're trying to run missions in a constellation where an incursion is in effect, that 1 million ISK NPC battleship is only going to pay you 500,000 ISK in bounties. And that's going to remain in effect until the incursion ends one way or the other. The last two is of what's greatest concern to most pilots. Vessel integrity compromised, shield and armor resistances reduced, and capsule interference detected, turret, launcher, drone, and smart bomb damage reduced. So you take more damage than normal, and you deal less damage than normal. So if you're trying to run missions, and all of a sudden an incursion opens up in your current constellation, you're going to be less effective against those mission rats that you're trying to fight, and you're more liable to be destroyed by those mission rats because you're suddenly taking more damage from them. Oh, another thing to keep in mind is that the local belt rats will be replaced with the incursion rats. So it becomes a lot more dangerous to try mining in the celestial asteroid belts. And let me right-click an empty space, let me pick an asteroid belt, let me warp to it within 100 kilometers.
Warp drive active.
And we will take a look for ourselves. And let me left-click the stargate that I just left, because I may need to warp right back to it. There you go.
Warp drive active.
Uitra Telen, Uli Kuserbi, Eisterrombin. Extremely dangerous ships. Even the frigates. So if you're still trying to mine in the local asteroid belts and an incursion hits the constellation, they are going to fry your mining barge in about however long it takes for them to target lock you. So yeah, trying to mine in the local asteroid belts, bad idea. Now let's see. You can go to Neocom Journal, the Incursion tab, the Global Report subtab, and you can see a list of incursions currently in effect. And I like to sort this according to security level, so high security at the top, null security at the bottom. And while I'm talking, let me go to the staging system. Just set a course and close this. Now, if you have beacons on your overview, you will see extra beacons in the solar system, and they'll have names like Nation Commander Stronghold, Nation Consolidation Network, Overwhelm Civilians Facility, and so on. These are incursion sites that you can warp to that you can try fighting back against the Sansha. Though you need really good ship setups in order to be able to do that, and you also need to be part of a fleet. Otherwise, if you try to go in solo, you're going to be vaporized. By the way, you may see other celestial beacons in the system. This one, for example, is a rogue drone infestation sprout. That's a permanent feature of the system. That's there all the time. That was there before the incursion launched. That's not an incursion site. So don't confuse the incursion site beacons with the permanent beacons that are always present in a particular solar system. Now, part of the incursion profile is going to say Sansha staging, Sansha vanguard, Sansha headquarters, and so on. That indicates the general difficulty level of the sites you find in the system. And you can go to, let's go back to Journal, Incursion tab, the Encounters sub-tab. By default, these headers will be collapsed. You can left-click on each header to expand it. And you can read up on the different kinds of sites here. In the staging system, you'll only find scout sites. In the Vanguard system, you'll find nation mine colonies, nation commander outposts, override transfer arrays. In the assault systems, you'll find overwhelmed civilian facilities, nation consolidation networks. You get the idea. The incursion comes to an end when somebody, either when the time limit expires, or when somebody defeats a site called either the Kundalini Manifest or Ouroboros. Among players, this will commonly be referred to as a mothership fight, or a mom fight for short, because you're fighting a Sansha mothership, or basically a Sansha supercarrier. So, you can read up on the different kinds of sites here. I am now in the Sansha staging system. Every incursion constellation will have one and only one staging system, and you can see the different incursion site beacons that are present in the system. For the scout sites, if you try to warp to them,
warp drive active.
You will notice that those do not have acceleration gates. So I'm warping to this one at 100 kilometers, because I don't like flying around in a capsule, and if I stick around in my shuttle for too long, I will get my shuttle vaporized. By the way, flying around in a capsule in high security space isn't terribly dangerous, but if you happen to run into something nasty by chance, and somebody blasts your pod to smithereens without provocation, they're still going to get have their ship destroyed by Concorde, but you've been pod-killed anyway. So, I don't often like flying around just in my capsule. So I'm going to take a look at this, and then I'm going to get out of here. And you know what? Yeah. Time for me to warp out. It looks like somebody else is already running a scout site. Scout sites can be soloed with a good setup. Anyway, only the scout sites lack acceleration gates. Vanguard, assault, and headquarters of any kind, there are acceleration gates involved. But with that said, they will mostly all admit everything battleship and smaller. I think there's one exception where there's two gates and you need to send cruisers and smaller through one gate and battle cruisers and larger through another gate, but that's an odd exception. Oh, by the way, sometimes the asteroid belts, the celestial asteroid belts in the staging system only, also count as scout sites. So if you see this pop-up box when you start a warp to an acceleration to an asteroid belt, then that particular asteroid belt does count as a scout site, and you'll get Concorde loyalty points in ISK for wiping out the Sansha there. But that's only true in the Sansha staging system, not in the Vanguard, Assault, or Headquarters systems. Speaking of, I completely forgot to talk about the rewards if you do participate in fighting back against the Sansha. First, though, I want to warp right back to the Stargate, because I want to get out of here. Ah, good. Somebody else is already clearing this site.
Warp drive active.
So let's go back to Journal, and again, let's look at the Encounters subtab. You'll notice that there are two kinds of rewards. There is an ISK reward and a Concord loyalty point reward. Loyalty points I will cover in more detail on an episode specifically about loyalty points, so I won't go into much detail about them here. Suffice it to say that you can spend loyalty points in a Concord station. You can spend Concord loyalty points in a Concord station and get items from the Concord loyalty points store. Or, if you want to, you can exchange your Concord loyalty points for the loyalty points of any non-pirate corporation. Most players will not do that because they consider the Concord loyalty points to be more useful than any other corporation's loyalty points. So when you complete a site, you will be paid a certain amount of ISK right on the spot. An amount of Concord loyalty points will also be promised to you if somebody manages to defeat the Sancha supercarrier in that constellation at a later time. So here in this case, I was in another constellation. I was participating in running a bunch of Vanguard sites, so a whole bunch of Concord loyalty points were promised to me, right? But they weren't paid out to me at that time. When somebody else defeated the Kundalini Manifest in that particular constellation, the incursion was defeated, and everybody got their loyalty points. If the time limit had run out before anybody defeated the Kundalini Manifest in that constellation, all these loyalty points in the pool here would have been thrown out. I would not have gotten any of them. It doesn't have to be you that defeats the Sancha Supercarrier for you to get your loyalty points. It's just that somebody has to defeat the Sancha Supercarrier. So you get your ISK right away, and your loyalty points later if the Supercarrier is defeated. Speaking of the time limits are expressed in three phrases. When it first appears, it'll be Incursion Established. After a number of days, it will switch to Incursion Mobilizing, and another couple of days after that, it'll say Incursion Withdrawing. When it says Incursion Withdrawing, you have less than a day to defeat the Sancha Supercarrier before the Incursion withdraws of its own accord, and Concord considers that a loss, and throws out everybody's loyalty points for that constellation. Alright. I've probably done enough talking for an introductory episode. I may at a later time cover the ships and fittings required to actually run such a site. But in the meantime, thank you for watching.